the Soul Stone has been a major part of discussion when it comes to MCU fans ever since, I would say, Guardians of the Galaxy, really, where they made it a point to let us know that these things are going to be huge and important, and each one is very powerful. So start, you know, mapping your star charts and connective tissue and MCU, you know, flows and theories and everything. And of course, we've heard the, I guess, craziest theories to the most unlikely scenarios of where the Soul Stone might be. But what happens and where it's located was pretty much something that nobody could have guessed. Now, of course, spoilers alert for this video, quite obviously, but I am going to talk about how the Soul Stone works and where it was found. So, of course, the Soul Stone has finally, you know, showed up in Infinity War, and we get the full explanation of how it works and what exactly it can do. And essentially, you know, what the Soul Stone's, like, purpose was that it sat there and you had to make a sacrifice to it. You had to sacrifice a soul in order to unlock it. Now, you can't just bring anybody. You can't just, like, kidnap somebody you don't know, toss them down into this, like, you know, pit, and the Soul Stone shows up. It has to be someone you genuinely love as they're your own. And the Soul Stone can more or less, like, detect if you're telling the truth, right? Because this is a powerful entity, it's a powerful thing in a universe, and it has this, like, magical property of the way it manifests itself. So when you do it, it will know. So when Thanos sacrifices Gamora, he's crying because he genuinely loves her as his own daughter, and that's why he's able to get the stone. Which means when he's fully able to finally utilize it at the end of Infinity War, when he snaps his fingers, he's already sacrificed one soul he loves, so he doesn't need to do any more. Which is why he's able to do that. It's not like, oh, he loves all of humanity, so if he snaps his fingers, he could kill half of them. No, he's already paid his dues due to the fact that he actually was able to sacrifice someone he loves. Which honestly is quite awesome, in the fact that it was on a planet that nobody suspected, you know, and something like that, and that Gamora actually knew the whereabouts of it, I thought was pretty awesome. And I just honestly can't wait to see how they're gonna throw more curveballs at us down the road.